The following is a presentation of Two Sports, the leader in local sports coverage.
School football regular season finds Two Sports in Allentown at J. Bernie Crum Stadium for the Lehigh Valley Conference opener between Dieruff High School and the Patriots of Freedom. Good evening and welcome to Lehigh Valley Conference Football. Mike Zambelli joined by Jim Wills as we do indeed start counting them for keeps here today. Last week was a preview or a warm-up for all of the teams, with the Freedom Patriots downing Stevie West, getting off to a quick start, winning by a final of 35-7. They are 1-0 on the year. Jason Roeder in his third year, and Jim Wills, if we heard it once, we heard it 10 times from area coaches how this is going to be a good football team. Don't underestimate Freedom. And if they are to be successful, it will probably go with the pass-catch combination of Joe Weaver and Colin Freitas.
Well, it will, Mike. Joe Weaver had a great game last week, threw for over 300 yards. Colin Freitas caught the ball for over 200 yards and three touchdowns. So that combination has been great, and they have a couple other wide receivers as well. So it's Weaver's start has really propelled Freedom into a lot of positive things here going into week two.
For the Dieruff Huskies, a 13-0 loser last week to East Stroudsburg South. Their losing streak has now spanned over the last two seasons and a total of 22 games. Again, if we've heard it once, we've heard it a million times. This is a different attitude. This is a different ball club. Keith Brader is back for his second term as the head coach. And you look at, really, offense has been their problem. They only scored 9 touchdowns a season ago. Sonny Odom's their starting quarterback, and he needs to play well and efficient for them to be successful.
He does, and last week he did a good job, Mike. He only threw for 76 yards, but, you know, you got to look at it. He threw 15 passes. They need to get that down pat this week and get a little bit more out of him. But the thing of it is, he's going to run that offense. They have athletes to score, and they could be very dangerous. The Freedom people know that, and they are really worried about this game right now. So, Dieruff, it's confidence, like you said. The changes are there. It's back to Keith Brader, and he's real happy with it.
Huskies have not won a varsity football game since October of the 2004 season. That, by the way, was the last time Keith Brader was their head football coach. Regina Patochny will be roaming the sidelines. We've got Lehigh Valley Conference football. Stay with us. Dieruff and Freedom, it's yours next.
Since the Overhead Door Company makes the original overhead door, the people who install and service them take them pretty seriously. Call or log on for the overhead door dealer nearest you.
Let's go get Yako. You know it's always been the best. Let's go get Yako. Yako hot dog is known worldwide. Let's go get Yako. The secret sauce is one of a kind.
Yako's, an Allentown tradition.
Take me out to the ball game.
Take me out with the crowd.
Buy me some peanuts and Cracker Jack.
I don't care if we ever get back.
So it's root
for the armpits.
If they don't win, it's a shame.
Cause 1, 2, 3
strikes, you're out at the old ball game.
Reserve your seats now at ironpigsbaseball.com or call 610-435-3001.
We'll be right back.
Last year, the 2006 season, Dieruff and Frieda met over in Bethlehem School District Stadium with the Patriots winning by a final of 45-16. Quarterback Joe Weaver ran for a touchdown to get things started, then Isaiah Wright, who we'll see run this evening for the Patriots, scored on a five-yard run, and the Patriots were on their way, winning by a final of 45-16. This is a new year, and you can really sense it with the feel from both coaches. Regina Patuchny has roamed the Lehigh Valley, has been to both practices, and Regina, you can sense the excitement coming out of both of these. Part of what is expected to be a big season of football around here.
That's right, Mike. You talk about the level of confidence and competitiveness here in the Lehigh Valley Conference this year, and this game is the pivotal of everything. You know, you talk about the Freedom Patriots, who across the league, the coaches are saying, hey, they're a team that can come out and surprise you, where you'll have the Dieruff Huskies under new head coach Keith Brader, who's back around for the second time here for the Huskies, and they say, you know, our enthusiasm is there, our confidence is there. We just need to get that one win under our belts, and we'll be good to go. So they're under here. They're ready to go as well. They need those big plays to come through for them, and the Freedom Patriots aren't backing down from anything. Every coach across this league this year is telling us, you know, we can't take any week lightly, and right now the Freedom Patriots are worried about their game here tonight at J. Bernie Crum.
Thank you, Regina. Enjoy your evening, and before we get into tomorrow, a happy birthday to you. Yours is tomorrow, and we also would like to wish a happy birthday to John Walson Jr., our president and owner, celebrating a birthday yesterday. So, Mr. Walson, happy birthday. Enjoy the football game here tonight as you get a look at Keith Brader. He's now in his second term here in terms of being the head coach. And, Jim, as you look at Jason Brader, a terrific football player at Bethlehem Catholic. He was part of that state championship team in 90. He was a sophomore on that team and then went on to continue his career at Moravian. But turning our attention to Keith Brader, a better football coach, at least he feels, having served under Joe Bottolari at Emmaus. This first quarter being brought to you by Kleckner & Sons Appliances. Logan Davis, one of the two deep backs for the Patriots, and fielded in a wide open to the 30, and this is number 34, Logan Davis to the 30. No markers down on the play. Touchdown, Patriots.
Well, Mike, second week in a row that the Patriots start out with a bomb of a play to start the game. Last week, it was the first play from scrimmage with a long bomb into the end zone for a touchdown. Second time in 2 weeks, you have the Patriots up early in the ball game on a great run there.
Number 34, Logan Davis.
And you see that middle opens up. He makes one good move, and then he just knows he's just going to have to outrun the rest of the people into the end zone as Logan Davis scores a touchdown early here for the Patriots.
Took all of, 14 seconds to get on the board. 92 yards, Davis into the end zone. And now on to attempt a point after is Jeff Schaefer. Schaefer, their kicker a season ago. He made all five of his kicks in last week's win against CB West. And is now 6-for-6 on the season. Last season, Schaefer as a junior, 25 extra points overall, 23 in conference play, and boy, this is the way you draw it up if you're a special teams coach.
Well, the thing it is, he takes that middle slot. He only has to make really one move there, and after he makes that one move, it's just a foot race down the sidelines, and then he goes into the end zone untouched. And this is such a big advantage. We talked to Coach Roeder before the game about last week's game when they were up early, and when you get up early, Mike, that just gives you such confidence going into that first defensive series.
Well, a lot of people talking about Freedom, as we mentioned, and you know, I had an opportunity to talk with both coaches a couple of times during the week, and they were very informative. You know, Coach Roeder put a very positive spin. I asked, you know, we always ask a coach, has there anybody been a surprise through camp? And he said, you know what, Mike? He says, everybody's doing what we've expected of them. I said, well, that's a good thing. And he agreed with that, you know, the coach, the players now know him. He knows the program. The players know what's expected of them, and off to a good start here in week number two.
You know, that's what they, you know, they had a great training camp. His third year in charge, you know, things have really progressed. One of the brightest young coaches in the league, doing an outstanding job of motivating this group. He's got some talent here this year and some real good football players on his team. So expect some real good things out of the Freedom Patriots here this year.
Schaefer now to kick off. One of the deep guys is Rodney Gilmore, and he's going to get an opportunity, or no, he's not. That ball goes into the end zone. High school game, you can't run it out. Rodney Gilmore is a sophomore running back for the Huskies. He is a young man you will see an awful lot in this game. So first and 10, Dieruff from their own 20 and already trailing 7-0.
Well, this is going to be another test for the Huskies, Mike. We've talked about how tough it's been. They haven't won a game in a long, long time. And, you know, they played a good game last week, but now they're down already 7-0 here very, very early in the first quarter.
And the starting quarterback will be Sonny Odom. Stands 6'2", weighs 175. He's a junior. Ask Keith Brader. I said, does he realize the number he's wearing? He reminds me a little bit of a guy named Rocky Butler, who was a pretty good quarterback in his days as the Huskies. Here's the option, and Gilmore has the flip and has positive yards around right end. One of the things and the keys for Dieruff in this game, they can't have this be a track meet. That start couldn't be more detrimental in terms of what Keith Brader, he wants a slow kind of grinded out kind of game. Might even see a little wishbone from the Huskies offensive attack.
Well, you saw Gilmore there on the run. Mike, you know, they want to run the ball. Last week, the Patriots gave up a lot of yards on the ground to CB West, so they thought they could come in here running the football, and that's what they did there on that first play.
Odom on second down and 3. And the Huskies will keep it on the ground. And not much happening there for Courtney Coles, who's a big guy. He's a senior, 6'2", 231, but he got stood up at the line of scrimmage by, among other, Kyle Peters.
Well, you're also going to see number 66 come in there as well. And, you know, it's just a very, very good job of standing up. You see 66 come in there, Anthony Carter, 6'1", 255-pound senior guard inside. And he's, you know, a good one. A lot of good bloodlines with him as well.
Have some wide bodies in there. Peters, 6'3", 3 1/4. Gilmore, the motion man, now cuts it back between the tackles, and he will be stopped short of a first down, and the Huskies, in all probability, will have to punt the football away.
Number 22, Rodney Gilmore with the carry.
Now there you saw Kyle Peters coming out again. Good job inside. It's 6'3", 325 pounds. One of the biggest people on the Patriot line. Doing a good job there in that defensive stand.
Todd Micah, number 42, the starting linebacker for the Pates, also involved on the stop. Sonny Odom in punt formation from his own 15-yard line and barely gets that out of there. Left-footed kicker. And takes a Patriot bounce, and it will be first and 10 freedom from the Dieruff 43-yard line.
Number 12, Sonny Odom is down by number 45, Joshua Rodriguez.
First quarter being presented by Kleckner's Appliances with two locations to serve you, one in Whitehall, one in Emmaus. Now this becomes a pretty important sequence here for the Husky defense, to say the least, as you get a look at quarterback Joe Weaver, 6'1", 175-pounder in his senior year. He had one of the best openers of any quarterback in the state, throwing for 4 touchdowns and over 300 yards in their win against CB West. And he will throw on first down, pump fakes, and misses. His intended receiver is Colin Freitas.
Well, Mike, you know, we talked about this last week, about all the passing camps that teams have. You know, we were talking about the Whitehall-Beckett game last week about that. That's what people like Weaver really profited with over this summer. You know, they did a lot of passing scrimmages against a lot of different teams at Bethlehem Scrimmage Stadium during the summer. And a guy like Weaver, who's a tremendous passer to begin with, just profited so much from that experience over the summer.
Twins formation, actually a slot formation to his right. Lone back is Isaiah Wright, number 21, and he gets the call with some running room and a nice finish to that run as Odom coming up from the safety position to make the tackle, but not before a gain of perhaps 5 yards.
Isaiah Wright with the carry. Well, Isaiah Wright did not play last week, so now they have another weapon in that backfield. As you see, the delayed handoff to Wright, and does a good job of getting a couple yards upfield to produce a third down for the Pates.
One thing you will see out of this Dieruff team defensively, Sonny Odom is a terrific hitter as a safety. Third down and 5, football inside the Dieruff 40. Movement on the front from the Huskies, and this will be, if it is against them, very close to a first down. officiating crew led by Robert Klein. He is the referee. Joining him tonight, Bill Berkheimer, Mike Engelstein, Russell Saylor, and Tony Bauer. Patriots break the huddle, but officials not quite ready to get things going as the first down comes up a yard shy of a first down.
The clock's been running through this whole time, though, Mike.
And that is the concern.
I need 20 seconds back on the clock.
Now 8:14 right now.
Should be 8:34.
Well, you heard it. They'll readjust the clock. Elsewhere tonight in local high school football, Emmaus is at Easton. We'll have that one for you coming tonight. Same night coverage at 10 o'clock.
We need it. 20 seconds on the clock. The clock did not stop when we called time.
Nazareth is at Parkland. Allen is at Liberty. And Whitehall is at Northampton. All the action in the Colonial League this evening. Wilson Saucon Valley, Penn Argyle Caddy, Palmerton Bangor, Northern Lehigh at Palisades, Northwestern Salisbury, and Southern Lehigh is at Notre Dame. Third and a short one, and they give it to the fullback, and with the one and a whole lot more is number 33, Patrick Collins.
Quick hitter there that time by Patrick Collins. 5'11", 210-pound senior back.
He's stopped by number 12.
Taking the place of Zach Singley from last year in the Patriots lineup. Singley did a yeoman's job for the Patriots last year, got a lot of work. And you're going to see here Collins doing the job here this evening for the Patriots.
By our numbers, that's his first carry of the season, and that's a first down. First and 10, football at the 22-yard line. Here's Wright, slips one tackle. He's still on his feet, and a terrific effort gets him near another first down.
Number 21, Isaiah Wright with the carry. He's stopped by number 87, Mikel Rose.
Isaiah Wright with 11 carries for 82 yards in that season opener is showing you that he's come back and still in high gear here in the second game of the season. Nice job of running on the inside.
Well, I was just going to say something to you, Jim. They're waiting a long time to turn the lights on this evening, and now I just see them starting to warm the lamps up. Kind of overcast night, very muggy day throughout the Lehigh Valley. This turf retaining a lot of that heat, although it wasn't too bad when we were down on the field pregame, but this surface can get awful warm during those day games. Let's go visit with Regina.
Mike, you talk about the heat and the humidity, and definitely today is one of the hottest days we've seen in the past couple of weeks. And we talked with head coach Jason Roeder from Freedom before the game, and he said, you know, I think it's to our advantage tonight. We are so well conditioned. We had one of the hardest camps in his 3 years of being here. And he said, you know, last week we didn't cramp. We had one kid that cramped, which was our kicker. So he said, hopefully it'll be to our advantage tonight. We think that we are in good shape. He said, but you never know. He's come out here and play. And it's cooling down on here on the field with the lights just coming on, like you said, but it is going to be a factor.
That was interesting to hear Coach Roeder discuss his camp, and he said, boy, if I'd have tried that 3 years ago, I don't know how many guys I'd have left. That's the difference in this Freedom program, and they have also shown the ability to break big plays, obviously, with, what, four of them last week, and already a kickoff return, as Wright has plenty for, or moves it inside the 10 down to the 7.
Nice job by the left side of the offensive line. You see the big split out there, Mike. They caught Dieruff looking a little bit at that split, and they just popped him through that hole right away. Look at the hole that they created there as they do a nice job of coming across. Number 75, John Kaczmarek, coming around across there to put a nice block on.
Devon McNair, number 51, leading the defensive charge for Dieruff. Here's Wright. Spinning off a tackle, lost the football. It's loose in the end zone and recovered by the Patriots for a touchdown.
Number 21, Isaiah Wright with the carry. He fumbles in the end zone. The fumble's recovered by number 4, Colin Freitas.
Colin Freitas is the alert Patriot that came up with that football.
Well, we talked about Freitas having three touchdowns last week. Here he gets a real good gimme touchdown here, Mike, if you talk about that, as you see the ball go loose and Freitas, just standing in the end zone, ends up falling on the ball for a touchdown for the Patriots.
Schaefer on a low snap from center and a terrific hold by number 10, Will Vilecki. And it results into a made extra point, 14 to nothing, Freedom. Jim, looking at that replay, you know, while Wright fumbled the football, boy, I think as a coaching staff, you love how hard he ran. That's what you call smelling pay dirt, and he was trying to reach that thing out there and score six for himself. I don't know that you can be that upset with that kind of an effort.
No, look at, he's spinning, Mike. He's trying to extend himself. He puts the ball over the goal line, ends up fumbling it as he hits the ground here. You're going to take a look at it. It comes out. And Freitas alertly falls on that ball. But you're right, a great effort on that whole drive by Wright.
Justin Figueroa, number 65, was the defender for Dieruff that was able to jar that free. But Freitas alert to come up with the football. Six plays, 235, 43 yards on the drive for the Patriots. And we're getting a real good example, Jim, of what folks may have been talking about.
Oh, you see Freitas with the fumble recovery in the end zone. He scored three times last week. We talked about it. You know, he's been around a couple places. Liberty as a freshman. Notre Dame as a sophomore. Now has seemed to settle in here at Freedom this year and has had an outstanding opener and getting himself a touchdown here in the first quarter.
Yeah, he's been a running back at all those other locations. And Jason Roeder said, we're going to move you out there. And it certainly has paid big dividends to this point, early going of this 2007 season. Schaefer, high end over end kick. This will be Gilmore once again looking for an opening. And is, well, almost dragged down and then very good pursuit as he is eventually wrapped up by Joseph Liberati, number 35, a sophomore reserve fullback
Rodney
linebacker.
Gilmore with the return. He's brought down by number 35, Joseph Liberati.
Well, we've seen some great special teams play already, the kickoff return, and that was a nice, nice coverage play by the Patriots that time, number 26 down there first. Todd Pershinko down there to hold up and not finish the job, but did the initial hit contact, and that's what you want to see. Some great play from special teams is going to be a third of the game, so you want to get some great plays out of them.
First down and 10 from their own.
Well, Sonny Odom now with his team down already two scores. Gilmore the motion man and gets the toss. It's a decent block on the outside and twists his way for a gain of perhaps two. Nice close defensively by number 12, Ryan Tress, now into the ballgame.
So, Mike, you look at it right now, especially with 6:48 and counting left in the first period. This is a mental thing for the Huskies. They got to overcome this right now. You know, everybody's always reminding them how many games they haven't won in the past couple years. And, you know, being down this much this early is a mental part right now. They're physically able to come back here, but you got to get over that mental hump and get them some confidence here.
Odom on second and 8. Option near side, and he is dragged down on a good defensive play by number 66, Anthony Carter. Carter, one of the three captains this year, four captains, I should say, for the Pates.
You're going to see the option now here. Everybody covering their man, covering their lanes. Carter doing a good job coming in and making the wrap. As you can take a look at it here, perfect coverage. They had everybody covered, the pitch man covered. Everybody was in position, and Carter makes the deal happen.
Well, Jim, you know, to elaborate a little bit more on the Dieruff situation, you know, the one thing that, you know, the players, you know, while it, you know, probably is better and the attitude is better, and, you know, they have to remember that, you know, Freedom's not looking to be the program or the team that, you know, is the one that ended that 22-game losing streak. You know, especially a team that has aspirations of perhaps battling their way back to the District 11 tournament.
Well, that's a good point, Mike. You know, Freedom was on the cusp last year, had that great start, then kind of went into a little bit of a skid there in the mid-year and then at the end of the year as well.
Timeout being brought to you by ABE Doors and Windows. Thank all of our fine sponsors of high school football this season once again. Well, you're right, looking back to last year for Freedom, they opened up losing to Central Bucks West, actually winning 14-6, then beat Dieruff, lost to Parkland 27-7, beat Central, beat Allen. And at that point, we're in very good shape. But then they ran into the tough part of their season, really losing to Northampton by 7. Easton 39-0, lost to Becca 34-14. beat Nazareth 21-14 and then lost to Liberty in their traditional close to the season to wind out at 5-5 on the year.
You know, and that's their goal, is to get over that hump of being 500, and they want to, you know, make sure that they become more well-rounded as a team. I think that's what Coach Roeder's performance going into the year was going to be, you know, or his goals, I should say, going into the year, is we want to run the ball as well as pass the ball. We want to play great defense, and so far this year they've been showing a lot of that.
Well, you made a good point, Priest, prior to the game about, you know, Freedom has some offensive minds there that loves to be aggressive. As this pass is thrown too high and is picked off by number 22, that's Tyler Markwith. And Markwith has the Patriots in scoring position once again.
Number 12, Sonny Odom's pass.
Well, Sonny Odom now, and Dira forced to go into a passing situation. The left-hander throws it out there, and it's just over the outstretched arms of number 3, Javon Ferreira, and the recipient, number 22, Tyler Markwith, with the interception.
Well, quite honestly, that's not the way Dieruff could ill afford to fall behind two scores in this game. And Jason Roeder was very well aware of that. One of the things he shared with us was, we need to get off to a good start and get them out of their game. And that's exactly where he has the Dieruff team to this point. 10-yard line. Wright is the lone back, as Joe Weaver brings his Patriots under center. First and goal from the 10. And it is Wright. Hit at the 6, falls forward inside the 5. Tackle on the play by Sonny Odom.
Well, you can't, you know, not help but think about Sonny Odom. He's doing his job defensively here tonight. That's a third or fourth real good hit he's had. And I mean a good stick there as he comes flying up from that safety position to come up and make that tackle, but not before another good gain by Isaiah Wright.
Well, and those are the things, you know, when you hear coaches say it's different, you know, we may have lost, you know, those games, and, you know, nobody really cares about that right now, but there's a young man just threw an interception and comes back and makes a defensive play. He shows you, you know, a little character by doing that. And another good stick by the interior of the Husky defense, led, I believe, by number 53, Jonathan Nunes. Nunes, a 5'9", 198-pound sophomore. Good thickness, Jim, for a 10th grader.
Well, he is. They got some good size along that defensive line, Mike. And a new defensive coordinator this year in Bob Panty, you know, running that defense, former Whitehall head coach, coming over there to help Coach Brader run that defensive system right now. And, you know, this is a big test for them right here.
It sure is. If they have any aspirations of making this a football game, you get the sense Dieruff needs a stop here. Third and goal from the 6. Weaver to throw. Under some duress. Avoids the first wave. Now to the 5. Dives. End zone. Touchdown.
Well, give Weaver all the credit on that one, because he created everything that happened that time. He was under extreme pressure that time by McNair from the inside. You know, they were really, really got a lot of inside. Here you see McNair, number 51. You see him coming in there. Now he had an arm out, but Weaver gets out of that arm grasp, and then he decides to run the football in. Weaver is a very good runner, Mike, and you can see by that little run right there as he creates a touchdown opening and scores 6 more for the Pates.
Schaefer having a busy first quarter. Some movement and a penalty marker coming out. Started to say, Jim, and to finish my thought about the offensive coordinators and those folks with Freedom, you made a good point. I can't recall a Freedom team with this kind of explosiveness in the last 10 to 15 years. They have some burners and some people that they should be able to spread the field out with.
Well, they would be able to spread the field and score on anybody in any different position. There you see Coach Panty there and Coach Brader on the sidelines, obviously dejected right now as the score indicates. But, you know, it's a building process, and it's not going to turn over overnight. We all know that.
Extra point is up and good.
Number 1, Jeffrey Schaefer's extra point attempt. Good.
Take another look, as you see, once again, that great penetration by McNair, but then he gets out of that grasp. Number 8 has a shot at him, Courtney Coles, but you know what? Weaver's not, he's a seasoned veteran. He's a senior, Mike, and that's the thing. You see almost a face mask penalty called there to begin with. But Weaver's a seasoned veteran. He's been at the helm now for a while. He knows if everybody's covered, take that ball, tuck it, and run.
Well, and That's what Freedom really likes about this team. Last year, they did get off to a decent start. But what an experienced group. A lot of these young men, as we mentioned, played a lot of meaningful minutes last year for Freedom. And three plays after the turnover, Weaver from 6 yards out on the scramble. And the Patriots firmly in control of this one and early, and I think that has to be pleasing to Jason Roeder.
Well, you know, you saw them turn in the corner a little bit, Mike, again last year at the end of the year. You know, they had Liberty down early in that second quarter in that Liberty Freedom game last year, and everybody was really surprised as they came out and drove the ball down the field. And I think that those kind of games from last year, even though they ended up losing that game 48-14, that those are the kind of games that gave them confidence coming into this year. And you see players like Weaver getting those confident situations going in their direction again.
Schaefer's kick once again fielded by Gilmore. And a good burst gets the sophomore out across the 30-yard line. And the Huskies in desperate need of some offense. And again, you look at their numbers from last year.
He's tackled by number 8.
Average of 35 points per game. They only scored 9 touchdowns. All of the points scored by last year's team were by seniors. So they don't have a player on this football team that has scored a varsity point. They were shut out last week, 13-0.
Huskies, I mean, that's the
epitome of inexperience. Obviously, last week in their loss to East Stroudsburg South in the red zone on 5 occasions and didn't come up with any points.
That's an amazing stat when you think about that. You know, when you go into preseason camp, you at least have some people on your roster that scored some touchdowns a year before and some positive things. As you see athletic director Fred Harris there on the sidelines, very enthused, along with Mike Laporta, principal of Freedom High School, very enthused with Coach Roeder and the job he's done in the past couple years rebuilding that Patriot program.
Husky points last year, Nick Harding, their leading scorer, with 6 touchdowns. Marquise Keels with 2 touchdowns. Felix Santos had a touchdown. And John Pavinsky was their kicker. All of them lost to graduation. Gilmore the motion man, and the ball is loose. Picked up by, actually, that was the wide receiver, number 87, Mikel Rose, actually the tight end. And he saved another Dieruff turnover.
Fumbles recovered by number 87.
Now, this is exactly what Coach Brader did not want to see. You know, they're trying to get something going here. You get a fumble there from Courtney Coles out of the fullback position. Mikel Rose picks it up, I'm sorry. And, you know, just really couldn't do anything with it.
Freedom has scored 21 points in this first quarter. Weaver has attempted just 1 pass. Third down and 9. Clock moving at 2:23, still in the first quarter. Odom to throw, left-hander moving to his right. He'll have no time. Swarmed under, led by Todd Micah, 6'1", 210-pound senior.
Odom is sacked by number 42, Todd Micah.
Well, you're going to see from the bottom of the screen, he comes in right off of that, you know, middle part of the field. Really has an open shot at Odom. And help get some help there from the rest of his Patriot teammates. But very good job defensively once again by the Patriots.
I think it has to be real disconcerting, of course, to Keith Brader. He really felt he was going to be able to move the football today in terms of running it. But they have been forced into a game that they don't want to be involved in terms of having Odom throw the ball. Here's a good punt fielded by Youssef Reddick. Reddick back in action after missing last week, and the Huskies with good special teams work.
Odom's punt.
Leonardo Perez, number 50, one of the first dogs down.
By number 4, Carlos Garcia.
Trivia question tonight brought to you by the good folks from R&J Carpet Connection. When was the last winning season for Dieruff football, and who was the head coach? We told you when they had their last win. I said to you, we'll answer that later. I said to you, Jim, I gave the trivia question away. I forgot which one. I didn't give it away.
No, you didn't.
No, I didn't. I said when they had their last win, 2004.
You threw me off there. I thought I had the answer.
Well, when was the last win? You thought, yeah, you were paying attention.
I still think I have half of it, but I'm not sure.
All right. I'll give you a little something to think about tonight. Last winning season for the Dieruff Huskies, and who was the head coach? Here's Weaver attempting just his second pass. Freitas has a step on the defender, but closing and knocking it down was Rondell Byers.
there was a big, big plus for the Huskies. If they could, if Byers could have held on to that football, that would have been a very, very big play for the Huskies. You see how Weaver has a really, really strong arm. He's throwing it out here intended for number four, Colin Freitas. But it just hangs up there a little bit. Might be that air we have tonight, that humidity, very, very thick. And it hung up there a little bit to give time for Byers to get underneath and intercept, or excuse me, knock the ball down.
Incomplete pass. Second down and 10. Weaver on the keeper, has a first down and spins and then is stood up. There's Odom again on the tackle, but not before Weaver has enough for a first down.
Number 7, well,
we talked about Weaver did a great job last year running the football, and he's coming out this year again as you see Coach Brader trying to figure out what they're going to do here defensively to stop Freedom. Freedom giving him a lot of different looks, and when your quarterback is able to run the ball like Weaver has been able to, that's just yet another weapon for you to have to deal with.
Trips formation this time to the right of quarterback Joseph Weaver. Weaver, one of the captains this year for the Pates. And he is looking in that direction, goes to the middle man, and Freitas had it. Is that a completion or no? Reddick picks up the football and is into the end zone. And they are rolling it, a completion, a fumble, and a touchdown for the Pates.
Oh, Mike, just the way they drew it up on the board. That's the play that Coach Roeder was drawing up on the board right before they came out. They went to see, they tried to do the hook and ladder, but you know what happened? The hook and lateral didn't happen, but a lateral forward did. There you go. It's Riddick in the right place, right time. Talk about their receivers tonight. Freitas being in the right place at the right time. That time, Riddick being at the right place at the right time.
Well, Yusuf Riddick, you'll recall that name as a sophomore. He played some very meaningful minutes for the varsity basketball program last year. He has some great speed, 5'7", 145. And finishes what Frieda started.
One, Jeffrey Schaefer,
and that is a 28-0 lead for the Pates.
The Weaver rifles that one inside. Freitas goes to make a spin move. Ends up slipping out of his hands. There you take a look at that ball right on target by Weaver. Freitas comes out of that spin move without the ball, and Reddick is the recipient of that right into his hands.
A good call by the official. Looked like there was a couple of shuffles or steps in there to rule that a completion. Huskies again with a pretty good hit to force the Pates to put it on the carpet, but it has been the opportunistic Freedom team that has been able to cash them both in for touchdowns. That's a rarity. You force two fumbles and you have them both go for touchdowns. That'll leave you scratching your head. Three plays, 53 yards. Yusuf Reddick on the fumble recovery.
Well, both of these drives, both under a minute and a half. So, you know, they're scoring at a rapid clip. As you see, Coach Scully there, one of the offensive coordinators, they really even had that much time here tonight to get their offense in gear. You know, they've really haven't run that many plays here, obviously, in the first quarter and have scored 28 points.
Well, they picked up where they left off last week. It is a big play capability team, and they are showing it in their first, well, this into their second game of the season. Huskies with another pretty good return. That is David Irizarry, one of the captains. Running back, he's a starting outside linebacker as well. Irizarry, one of the players that Keith Grader gave high praise to through camp.
Number 20, Kissam Alozio.
Perhaps the final play of what has been a dismal first quarter for Dieruff. Odom to throw. Has his man, the pass is complete to Carlos Garcia. Garcia into Freedom territory and down to the 22-yard line.
Odom's pass completed to number four.
Nice job by Odom there, threading that ball in there. Garcia, the senior, 5'11", 175-pound wide receiver, picks it in, takes a look and goes up the sideline. has one man to beat, number 10 there, Will Vilecki, but he has to turn it to the inside, and then Vilecki gets help on the tackle.
First down of the football game for Dieruff. That will do it for the first quarter. Keith Brader's Dogs down 28-0.
The Family Prescription Center in Bethlehem has served the needs of its customers for over a century. We want to help you save money on your prescriptions by offering the Family Care Plan. By enrolling in this program, you get the benefit of discounted pricing even if you are not covered by an HMO prescription plan. Individual membership is only $35 a year, and family membership is only $50 a year. Call us today at 610-866-0709 or stop by the Family Prescription Center today to enroll in the Family Care Plan and start saving.
Well, the school colors fit right in there to the Pittsburgh Steelers. That's a tailor-made uniform. You can double up with that. Hello there, young lady. Terrific night for high school football. Breeze kicking up over off of Lake Muhlenberg. And Jason Roeder is riding a 28-0 lead. He's going to be ecstatic. You know, it's interesting, Jim. And he's very confident in this group, and you can tell by talking to him. Wasn't concerned a little bit about perhaps maybe looking past Dieruff here tonight in anticipation of a pretty important showdown next Friday in their ballpark against Parkland.
Well, I think, Mike, he for the first time in the 3 years has the confidence in that he really has some football players in his lineup. You know, the first couple of years with the rebuilding going on, they really didn't have that many quality football players in their lineup. They had a couple of people, Colin Neely and those kind of people, but as far as 10 to 12 to 15 to 17 type quality football athletes, he's got that on his team, and I think that's why his confidence level is so up.
Well, they're not getting, you know, you look at, I guess, East Hills and the feeder system that comes in there, you know, they're not real big winning seasons there, and so I think it speaks volume for what Coach Roeder and his staff have been able to accomplish. And we mentioned the size of some of these guys. There's obviously a great deal of work going on in the weight room. Odom, fortunate to get back to the line of scrimmage, if he did, was under some good duress. I believe Dan McMahon, it was McMahon, number 76, now in there defensively. McMahon, an example of what we're talking about, 6'2", 245, and he might be one of the smaller guys along the offensive and defensive lines.
Yeah, he's done a real good job, and that guy right there is to get most of the credit. You know, he's taken a program, you know, over that, you know, had done some good things, but then they really weren't sold on a few things, and he's pushed the weight room, he's pushed the speed camps, and, you know, and the passing scrimmages, as I said, they had a lot of them during the summer, and they just keep getting better and better every week.
Here's Odom in a run once again, and good pursuit by the Patriots defense. Todd Micah again on the tackle, number 42. That's the second or third time that Mr. Odom's lost his helmet in this football game.
He's tapped by number 42, Todd Micah.
You take a look once again, good penetration there on the outside by Pompey. That causes that play to really stop in its tracks. As you see,
Club is running a 50-50 round.
Sonny Odom with that helmetless look down there. I'll tell you, that young man deserves a lot of credit, Mike. It's 28-0, and I'll tell you what, he's given it his all on every single play offensively and defensively.
His offense now faced with fourth down and 7. Football just inside the 20. Odom with the trips formation to his left, and he dropped the snap from center. Ah, the growing pains. The growing pains you're going to have to endure. Yeah, everybody's talked about improved numbers, and there are. They started with 72. They have 65 still, you know, showing up for practice. But, and Keith Brader is very well aware of it. He's not going to be happy with his first half, and probably not going to be a real pleasant locker room at the half, but now, I like to give credit where it's due, and I think the guys wearing the white uniforms tonight are taking care of business.
Yep, they've done an outstanding job of jumping off early. When you are in that rebuilding situation, Mike, especially from them, you know, as you said, not really even that many touchdowns coming back as far as last year, none. It's a tough situation, and it's more mental than it is physical. I think physically they can match up a little bit, but the mental part is where it gets you.
Now they're getting beat on the line of scrimmage right now. Weaver handing off to his fullback, Patrick Collins, has a couple of nice runs already in this game. That appears, well, now when they spot it, it might be about a half yard shy of a first down.
You know, you're talking about kids that are juniors and seniors that haven't experienced winning a football game. And to me, that's such a mental thing to get over. That, you know, the physical part, you can help and help and help, but the mental part, and really getting down tonight early didn't help that mental part of theirs.
Dan McMahon, number 76, terrific trap block on that last play. Wrights the lone back, Weaver to throw. As his receiver, Frieda, slips a tackler and dives forward to the 47-yard line. Let's go down on the field and Regina Potocny.
Mike and Jim, you speak of the growing pains that Dieruff is going through, and obviously they've had a tough couple of years losing 22 games in a row, but Keith Brader, coach of Dieruff, he's like, I don't want to harp on that. You know, these kids enjoy coming to practice. When I was there last week, you know, the intensity, I was so shocked about the intensity. These kids want to be there. They're learning the game. All three captains told me, you know, Coach Brader's in school with us, and that is helping us so much, just having a head coach around, keeping these kids interested. If you look across the field, that sideline is packed with athletes. Like you just said, they have to get into the game and get through these growing pains.
Yeah, exactly. Jake Williams, who was the two-year head coach the last couple of years, and teacher at Easton, and you know, wasn't there. Not a knock on anybody. That's, you know, the direction they chose for the program at that point. And you know, it's one of the improvements that many feel was made with the hiring of Keith Brader. Second down and eight here, and 8:26 to go, second quarter. Still a very humid, hot night. More to come tonight. Same night coverage of Emmaus and Easton, a game with great intrigue from Cottingham Stadium. Same night coverage tonight at 10. Weaver to throw, and throws a nice pass out to Will Vilecki. Vilecki got the party started last week with that long touchdown pass on their first play. That, I believe, his first reception of this game.
But Weaver's got a lot of choices. You know, he's got Friedis out there. He's got Vilecki. That's the thing, that he's done an outstanding job with spreading the ball around. There you see both of them that time out on the right side. Vilecki, 6 foot, 175-pound junior, hauls that one in.
That's a nice pitch and catch. That was pretty well defended. Huskies had a guy underneath and a guy in a trail position, and Weaver just made a better play offensively. First and 10 Pates, just inside the Dieruff 40. Weaver hands to right, high stepping through the defense, and is down to the 30.
Number 21, Isaiah Wright with the carry.
Mike, you talked about it already. They have the perfect combination now. You got Isaiah Wright, you got the running on the inside, the outside speed with Wright, you got the passing on Weaver. You know, this is going to make all defenses honest to all different things. Now, you see, they pass the ball, then they come right back with that run right up the middle of the line, and look at the hole that's opened up there and the pounding that Wright does inside to get those yards.
Nate Soto on the tackle, getting a good block on that play, was number 66, Anthony Carter. Second down and a short one. Wright the lone back, Weaver will throw. Underneath, here's Reddick. Spins out of a tackle, touchdown, Patriots.
Touchdown, Patriots.
Jim, I don't know that I have ever seen a Freedom team with these kind of weapons offensively. I understand Dieruff and 22 losses in a row, but I mean, they're going wide, they're going inside, and we are seeing an explosive offense here.
This is one of the first times in a long time that they've ever had all those combinations, Mike. You're right. And, you know, they got the speed at wide receiver, they got the ability to catch at wide receiver, and they got the tough running inside with Wright. So, you know, Weaver, the veteran quarterback, and this is the first mistake right here that the Patriots have made all evening long.
Yeah, they're going to toss it around. Look like Carol, your premium there for a minute. I was having flashbacks. But that is really the first mistake made by the Pates in this first half.
Hey, you see, pinpoint pass there. Weaver couldn't have put it any better than he did that time to Reddick. Right on the fly. Good job with the hands out there. Youssef brings it in and scores the touchdown.
34-0 Freedom. Looking to improve to 2-0 on the season and well on their way.
Freedom
34-0.
You see, that took 2 minutes and 42 seconds, which is probably the longest drive they've had all evening long.
Maybe all year. Long touchdowns they scored last week. Jason Roeder is assisted by Bob Feltman, Jeff Large, Sean McGinty, Jim Quintana, Todd Shimko, Jeff Haberl. Adam Legath has joined the staff, former Parkland graduate. Artie Owens, the great Artie Owens. Oh, what a good football
good?
Player.
People don't know how good he was.
Benjamin Rep, who is the offensive coordinator. Mike Scully helping out with the offense as well. Ben Rep calls their offense. He's in his third year as the coordinator. He spent seven seasons as an assistant at Albright College. Four-year starter, three-time all-conference tight end there. Elements are there, Jim, for this program. They have solid coaching staff. They have commitment from the, you know, we showed Fred Harris and, you know, the folks there at Freedom. You know, there's a commitment there. And Schaefer's kick deep into the end zone, and the Huskies will start from their own 20.
There's another weapon you have. Now, that kick almost went out of the end zone, Mike, on the fly. So, you know, when you see Jeff Schaefer number one there, that's another kind of weapon. When you talked about having all different kind of weapons, there's another one.
How about the college game this year kicking off from the 30? That's going to make a difference.
Oh, I would imagine that's going to make a big difference.
Create some excitement.
It's interesting. You hear a lot of different people talk about that.
Yeah.
You know, injury-wise, you know, ability-wise to get the ball. Right. It's just a lot of different things.
We'll see it firsthand tomorrow afternoon as Lehigh opens the 2007 season. We'll see the Mountain Hawks hosting the Villanova Wildcats live on Two Sports at 1 o'clock as we get a timeout here.
With 6 minutes, 54 seconds remaining.
Now, Jim, we were talking about the Patriots staff. Well, let's go to our trivia question here. And the last time that Dieruff had a winning football season, and who was the head coach? And if we can get a shot of Mr. Brader, he's the answer to our question. 2002, he guided the Dogs to a 7-5 record. I want to think that's the year that them and Allen played in the Eastern Conference Championship game.
I was going to say that was the year. I'm almost positive that was the year.
But there have been some lean years since that one. Can you believe a 3-38 record since that 2002 season? That's some lean times for a program that is rich in history and tradition, and, you know, to the days of Bruce Trotter and, you know, guys like Ross Moore, and we mentioned
guys like Mike Zambelli. Let's go there. I know you're not going to mention it, but I'm going to.
You know, Mike Marks is a coach, did some wonderful things. The 96 Husky team, they were 8-4. I think they finished runner-up to Parkland in the District 11 tournament. You know, the Rocky Butlers and the Tosh Riddicks.
Hey, they had some very good years. With, you know, Rocky Butler, a tremendous athlete. He could single-handedly lead a team anywhere. You know, and Riddick, you know, I remember him getting all those carries that year. And, you know, they had some really good athletes at that time. I think that they're on their way back. I think even though the score doesn't indicate that here tonight, I see a difference, Mike, from last year. You know, we saw them last year a couple of times, and I see a major difference, you know. But I really still believe that the mental part is tough to get over in high school, and that's going to take a while until they get that first victory. Yep.
Well, you threw my name in that hat, and I'll give Kleckner's a shot here at two locations, one in Whitehall, one in Emmaus, as a quarter sponsor. And, you know, one of the tough things, it's tough to talk about three wins and, you know, 4 or 5 year season, and it's tough to watch as an alumni. And I think there are enough people right now that are a little tired of it. We'll see what happens with it, see how they play out. You know, the first thing we, you know, wasn't so long ago, Liberty had, what, 37, 38 guys for Tim Muntzman, and, you know, they were able to turn that deal into something that's pretty special right now. Takes some time. This pass going to be picked off. That is Micah, I believe, squeezing into the left corner of the end zone. Todd Micah, an interception for a touchdown.
Well, what happens when the rains it pours and, you know, things are going bad for Odom and the Huskies right now. You can take a look at it here as Micah lines this ball up. Take a look at, you see number three going out there, Jovan Fiera, but he's just very, very underthrown. Micah steps in front. Foot race to the end zone and another Patriot touchdown.
Huskies are flat out involved in a game right now that Keith Brader wanted no part of. For them to have thrown as many passes as they have had to in this first half, is, and this thing has just gotten away from them. Schaefer drives through the extra point at his 41-0 tape.
Something good. And with 5 minutes, 56 seconds remaining in the first half, the Freedom Patriots lead.
Here, you take a good look at Coach Rader.
Good football player at Moravian
as
well.
Very good. Very good linebacker at Moravian.
Well, I started to talk as we look at the replay here in the touchdown, Jim, and you know, you can weigh in on it. Of course, Coach Roeder made some waves this past week looking to, you know, try and change sidelines over there. And, you know, I don't know right, wrong history. I know one thing. You know, he's fighting for his football team and he's fighting for his players, and that can't be a bad thing. I'm not going to weigh in on the logistics, whether it's right or it's wrong or it's this or it's that. And I know Keith Brader got off the Dieruff bus here tonight and walked into the stadium and looked to that far side and saw home of the Canaries and said, I want it changed. You know, it's the home of the Huskies tonight. So there are those little things that I think make football coaches successful in what they do. I applaud them. I'm not saying right or wrong. It should be done. And I guess we'll be able to find out next week, you and I, what sidelines they'll be on when they host Parkland, huh?
Yeah, that should be interesting next week. And, you know, you look at young guys. You saw a young guy last week in Tony Trisciani at Whitehall, enthusiastic, passionate about what they do. Jason Roeder the same way, and that's the thing. When you're that passionate about what you believe in and what you do and what you're in it for kids, those are the kind of decisions that you want to be made for your kids. And you know, you got to congratulate him, tip your hat to him, because he's going to fight for that every single time. And, you know, a lot of times people don't like the change of different things that happen, and, you know, that's going to be one thing that has to be dealt with by the higher-ups. But, you know, that's what he believes, and he's come in here and instilled a passion and enthusiasm, and that's the one thing. And when you're an administrator and you want to hire somebody, same way with that guy right there, a passion for what they're doing. You know, he's not having his way right now, obviously 41-0, but he's got a passion for what he sees in Deer football in the future.
For those of you who may have missed it, Coach Roeder was, you know, opting to get freedom when they play at Bethlehem Area School District to have his team camped out on the home side, which would contain the press box and make it a little bit easier for his coaches to communicate down on the sidelines. It would also give him a look cross field at the first down markers, and you know, just the general feeling of actually it being your home. It is Bethlehem Area School District, just like this is stadium, just like this is J. Bernie Crum Stadium, home to both Dieruff and Allen, and we'll see how it plays out. You know, bottom line is I'm not weighing in right, wrong. You know, it should be or it shouldn't be. I'm applauding a guy who's fighting for his football team and his players. Odom, his dog's in trouble, leading or trailing 41-0. And to throw once again, looking over the middle, had it on the hands of a receiver, maybe a reception, no. It was tipped up in the air by Mark Klutcherich, the intended receiver, and Javon Ferreira was battling vehemently and perhaps a little bit too much and might get flagged here for a little bit excessive.
No, it's just a frustration foul, you know, and he just did something he shouldn't have done, and he went after somebody in the face mask there, and the flag has been thrown.
Personal foul, blue. Gonna be, take him back. It's gonna be third down.
Gonna take a look at this after the tip play here. Now he's claiming that he caught the ball, so he's frustrated that the official doesn't give him that. So he gets up off the field, and then, you know, you see number five add his 2 cents in there, Jermell Lee. And then he reacts to that as well.
Yeah, that's you got to be tougher than that. You know, all of the intangibles, you need to be tougher than that. That's not within the rules of the game of football, and I'm sure Keith Brader and the staff will go over that with that young man. He's playing with a little fire in his belly and perhaps a little hurt, but that's still not part of the game.
Odom's pass intended for number 13.
Odom's pass falls incomplete.
That'll bring up a fourth down and long for your Huskies.
Yeah, Huskies once again will have to punt the football with Odom standing in his own end zone.
Oh,
Joseph Redick standing at his own 42. And that's right where he receives it. A little change of direction. Slips a tackler and a nifty little return for the junior inside the 35. There is a penalty marker down on the play, resting at the 22-yard line.
Odom's bunt returned by number 3, Yusuf Redick. He's brought down by number 3.
Score, Northern Lehigh 3, Palisades nothing. That's at the half, did you say, Donnie? Yeah.
Now you see a clip up there in the lower part of your screen. That's what the flag was all about.
32-yard punt, 7 yards on the return. Yeah, Brian Gilbert's guys said.
Holding on White on the return. It's going to be first down.
The official saw something different there than we did. As there is a holding call.
Move the football back to the 44-yard line, still in Dieruff territory. .448 remain in this first half, dominated by Freedom. From the I formation, right is the deep back. This is the fullback, number 33, Patrick Collins. Collins also will play some defense as a linebacker.
Number 33, Patrick Collins with the carry.
And would fully expect here maybe to see Freedom try and run this first half clock out when we would resume play in the third quarter. They already have it in a mercy rule scenario. Mercy rule runs the clock continuously except for special situations when a team is leading by 35 points at any point of the second half. Here's Weaver gunning downfield. He has 6 more. Boy, that's a terrific job by Weaver as he drops it into the hands of Will Vilecki.
Number 7.
Well, you know, what happens here is you come in here with a game plan. You want to see your quarterback get a lot of repetitions in the passing game. And here you see he does a great job once again in getting out of that pocket. He throws that ball on the run, and Vilecki hits it in stride.
Tough throw for a left-handed quarterback going in the direction he did and put it right on the numbers. What a terrific start to this year for Joe Weaver. Oh, yes. Schaefer tacks on the 48th point. Jim, I don't know that I've been involved in a high school game to see a high school team score 48 and a half.
Number 1, Jeffrey
Schaefer. Awful lot of points here as you're going to take a look once again. He's flushed out of the pocket. He's going to roll to his right. Now remember, he's a left-hander, but he tosses that ball right on the money as Vilecki is wide open as the defensive back got caught coming upfield. Byers got caught coming upfield on that, what it looked like that Weaver was going to run with the football. Mm.
Patriots, as we have mentioned, will play Parkland next week at Bethlehem School District Stadium. Dieruff will be over at the stadium as well in Bethlehem for a Saturday night ball game with Bethlehem Catholic. Visit with Regina.
Mike, you talk about the offense here for Freedom and how they have so many threats. We're seeing it on the ground and in the air. Last week, quarterback Joe Weaver threw for over 300 yards, 4 touchdown passes. Today, he already has 121, 2 touchdown passes. And we're seeing their ground attack, too. Isaiah Wright and also their other tailbacks and running backs have combined for 89 yards so far on the ground. So something Coach Roeder wanted to prove 2 weeks in a row, he has done it, saying they have a balanced attack on offense, and it's something that their opponents are going to have to worry about.
Yeah, there's no question about it. There is a lot to prepare for when you are looking to play Freedom. Kick is mishandled by Irizarry, and he is then swarmed under at the 4-yard line. So this leak in the dam gets a little worse against the Huskies
number
as
one,
they will
number
start from inside their own 5.
Number 13, David Irizarry. He's brought down by number 2.
Number Timothy 13, David Irizarry, 5'11", 175 pounds senior. Running back and outside linebacker. As we see Odom now jogging out to that huddle. Tough position to be in here now once again. First and 10, but way down in their own territory.
Looking at three things Keith Brader shared with me. Control the ball. Well, that hasn't happened. Limit big plays. That hasn't happened. And he fully expected to be able to run it. And I would look for him now maybe in this situation to try and get something going with the running game. Again, you know, this is an unforgiving game. There's nobody going to feel Dieruff, sorry for Dieruff, especially when they're on the other side. You have to earn that respect. You have to earn what has to happen. And somehow, some way, this Dieruff coaching staff has to take a positive out of this football game here. You know, with 3:32 to go in the second quarter and facing the mercy rule in the second half. Gain of 4 on first down. Gilmore gets it out across the 10. Huskies will be faced
number
with Thornton's third and short. Correct myself, that was
by number 11,
Anthony Coons, one of the captains on the carry. Coons, one of the young men that Keith Brader spoke highly about, having a good camp this summer.
You take a look at underneath there that the, you know, the offensive line still doing a good job there. You know, they just haven't had many opportunities to open up some holes here this evening. You know, they've really been caught back on their heels right from the opening play of the game.
There's the toss. Gilmore stood up in the backfield. Now change of direction. That is great pursuit. That is a nice job. Jermel Lee, who led the team in tackles last week with with 10 of them.
Number 22, Rodney Gilmore with the carry.
Tracking down Gilmore.
Jermel Lee.
Well, Dieruff came into the game thinking they could get some outside things going with the run game, but that hasn't materialized as well, as Jermel Lee has been one of the people from the Patriots who has done an outstanding job of tracking down that ball carrier.
Odom to punt from deep in his own end zone. And only 10 Dieruff players out there, I believe. 2, 4, 6, 8, 10 is right. Yeah, the things you have to endure, eh, Jim? Seen this scenario a lot of times.
Too many times with them, you're right.
Yeah.
Your Dieruff Huskies use their final timeout.
Use their final timeout of the half. Those are some of the things you deal with in terms of, you know, inexperience. And, you know, you're looking at a football team that basically has no experience in terms of varsity playing time. All these new names, pretty new. Huskies now 0 for 6 in third downs. It's a good effort by Odom. Here's Reddick from about the 37. Wrapped up by number 20. Alex Rodriguez.
You see Rodriguez there, pumped up for the Huskies. You know, you got to look for anything you can right now. That was good play on special teams from number 20 there. Only a junior, 5'5", 155-pound Alex Rodriguez.
Now, the other thing that needs to be discussed with Dieruff during summer camps, Betty Reinhardt, whose son played here a couple of years ago, you know, fed the Dieruff athletes through their two-a-day sessions through Yarnell's Catering. She's been doing that for the last 4 or 5 years. And, you know, those are some special people that are within programs, and I know these youngsters appreciate it. We mentioned those at, you know, some other places, but that's a good thing happening. Here's a good defensive play for Dieruff, and have come up with a loose football. Number 53 on the fumble recovery is Jonathan Nunez. Was a new quarterback in there, Ryan Tress.
Patriots fumble on the play. Fumbles recovered by the Huskies.
Take a look at here. Fakes inside and then goes to the pitch to the outside where number 21, Isaiah Wright, can't handle the ball as Tress comes inside, fakes inside to the fullback and then pitches outside. Now, the way he pitched that ball, Mike, a little bit of a tough thing to handle for Wright.
Zari, number 13, was one of the original, made the original play at the point of the pitch. Tough play to run for a reserve quarterback coming in on your first one. Here's Odom. Finding Garcia, second time in the ballgame. Those two have hooked up. That'll get it into Freedom territory, down to the 37.
Well, you see him. He's a lot more confident now back there. Protection was very, very good. The offensive line did a nice job creating a pocket for him. And a good completion downfield to Garcia.
Dylan Markwith into the ballgame, number 41 for Freedom. Odom not getting the snap from center. That twice in this game.
That's the kind of things, you know, of all the things that went on tonight, those are the kind of things that'll drive Coach Brader absolutely nuts. The bad snaps.
Been pretty calm over there this evening.
Hey, watch, we're going to take a shot at the end zone. Pass first, run second.
You take a look here. Just, you know,
never got
that,
it up. Never got the got snap up. Up. Keith Brader in his fifth year overall as a head coach at Dieruff, his alma mater, of course, where he starred back in the mid-'80s, mid to late 80s. 53rd game, 14 wins. Here's Odom finding Garcia once again. And that combination started to clip for the Huskies down to the 15-yard line.
Good job is here as he rolls out. This is his power side, being a left-hander. Nice little zip on the ball there as Garcia brings in yet another pass. Garcia found that seam right between two defensive backs, pulls it in.
On first and 10, Odom sets, fires, fortunate that one wasn't picked off. Tyree Pompey,
Carlos Garcia falls incomplete.
In the neighborhood, looked like he got a hand on it.
Once again, intended for Garcia. As you take a look there at Pompey, number 8. 5'10", 185-pound junior. Freedom rotating a lot of kids back in that secondary and linebacking core right now with the 48-0 lead.
Second down, 10. Odom play action. Lofts it into the near end zone. Reddick's got two hands on it. Was he in play? No. Good effort by Youssef.
That time Odom threw into double coverage.
Odom's pass.
And you're going to take a look at it here. It was intended for Byers, but it was overthrown and very, very close play there on the end line as Riddick uses his wide receiver skills that time to bring that ball in.
Third and 10.
Odom's pass intended for number 4, Carlos Garcia, goes incomplete.
Odom to Garcia misconnects. And it will bring up a fourth and 10. 9.4 seconds to go in the half. One that Keith Brader and his staff would like to forget. Garcia, who's been Odom's target, is split wide right. Looking in the other direction, will not have an opportunity. 3 to 4 white jerseys immediately around Odom. For last guy up there was number 9. That's Colin Rice. Rice, a number change.
Sonny Odom is sacked by number 9, Daniel Ruiz.
They're mentioning Ruiz. Ruiz no longer with the team. Colin Rice wears number 9 right now for the Pates.
Oh, that's the first time in a while that they got tremendous pressure inside from the defensive front four. Odom not a chance to even get that ball off. You see Ryan Tress, the backup quarterback, 6'1", 185-pound junior, coming into the ballgame right now.
to lead the Patriots in this last couple seconds.
He'll take a knee, and that will do it for the first half. The Patriots dominating from opening kickoff as Jason Roeder will take a 48-0 lead into the locker room.
Hi, this is Mike Mittman. Are you looking for a vehicle like brand new, only 1, 2, 3 years old? Do what I do. Come to Eberhardt Motors. Isn't that right, Eric?
That's right, Mike. We've been saying that for years. At Eberhardt Motors, I handpick only the best, and there's nothing here I wouldn't put in my own driveway.
And Eric, don't forget, all the cars are Advanced Star certified and ready to roll right off the lot.
Of course I know, Mike. I'm the owner.
Eberhardt Motors, been here doing it right for over 80 years.
Since the Overhead Door Company makes the original overhead door, the people who install and service them take them pretty seriously. Call or log on for the overhead door dealer nearest you.
Okay, now like I said, one smooth motion.
Hey, it's purple. That's magic.
Hey, good job, you guys. That was terrific. Hello, I'm Rachel Marie Brooks, Miss Pennsylvania 2007. And I'd like you to know that Big Brothers Big Sisters brings magic into the lives of children every day. And you can, too, by golfing with us at our 23rd annual Golf for Kids' Sake. I can't think of a more important investment than bringing someone special into the life of a child. I urge you to pick up the phone right now and reserve your spot at Golf for Kids' Sake. And you will turn some little moment into
big magic.
Join us for Golf for Kids' Sake 2007 at Southmore Golf Course on Wednesday, September 19th. To reserve your foursome, call Big Brothers Big Sisters Lehigh Valley at 610-391-1827.
On September 22nd and 23rd, the historic Victorian streets of Bloomsbury, New Jersey will again be transformed into the 8th annual Bloomsbury Fine Arts and Fine Crafts Festival. Recognized by Sunshine Artist Magazine as one of the best shows of its type on the East Coast, 100 exhibitors will display and sell their one-of-a-kind works in jewelry, paintings, photography, and much more. The festival will feature crafts for children, food, and live entertainment. Both the event and parking are free. For more information, visit BloomsburyArtsFest.com.
Days I leave my car at home, I ride the bus, the smart choice.
Atlanta Metro is the comfortable, fast, clean, and low-cost way to make your way around the valley.
Atlanta Metro, the smart choice.
We'll be right back.
Dieruff Husky Band. The band is presenting part of its 2009 show, The Music of Chuck Mangione. The band is under the direction of Mr. Frank DeSimone and assistant Brett Bob Priestess. Student music leaders are Joelle Birch and Julie Montez Dioga. And now, give it up for the hardest working band in Allentown, the Dieruff Husky Band!
Thank you. Beatles!
Caring teachers. Disciplined, safe, structured environment. College-bound students. Academic excellence. Values for a lifetime. All this and more. Do you want these things for your teenager? Bethlehem Catholic and Allentown Central Catholic. High schools of the Diocese of Allentown. Students who are learning to change the world.
Since 1937, Walter's Pharmacy has been making life easier for you. The name you trust most when you need your prescription filled. That's because getting your prescription right is our number one priority. And only Walter's Pharmacy delivers anywhere in Allentown for free. Our wide selection of health products and mobile equipment, as well as our convenient hours, make Walter's Pharmacy the fast and convenient choice.
I went to Walter's Pharmacy and they were able to supply all of my child's needed medications.
I call Walter's Pharmacy for all my prescriptions and healthcare items and have them delivered to my door.
Walter's Pharmacy in Allentown.
This fall, NFL Network presents the return of Thursday and Saturday Night Football, starting Thanksgiving night, when the world champion Colts take on the Falcons. Eight unforgettable NFL games, with the playoffs on the line, live in prime time. The run to the playoffs returns Thanksgiving night on NFL Network. Thursday and Saturday Night Football on NFL Network is available in HD.
Service Electric Cable TV presents the 8th annual Donald Hunt American Heroes Golf Classic on Monday, September 17th at beautiful Southmore Golf Course in Bath. Enjoy a great day of golf, dinner, and prizes, with all proceeds going towards the KVM National Education Center to honor all veterans. Don Hunt believed, like so many of you, that our freedom starts with our vets, past, present, and future. Call or visit our website for more information.
I'm Ryan Howard, and I'm hog wild for Iron Pigs Baseball.
See Major League Stars of Tomorrow at Coca-Cola Park.
What does it do to the likes of a mud hen? It's pretty much stomping into the ground. When breakfast, I have to have bacon.
The excitement begins April 2008. Full season and 18-game plans on sale now.
I'm Chase Utley, and I'm hog wild about Iron Pig Baseball.
Reserve your seats now at ironpigsbaseball.com or call 610-435-3001.
Service Electric today to order Cinemax on digital cable.
We welcome you back to J. Bernie Crum Stadium for our first half highlights, and this party got started early. Jim Wills, Logan Davis, the opening kickoff. They did one better than they did a week ago, where they scored on their first offensive play. Here they did it on the very first play of the game, and it's been all downhill for Dieruff since then.
Definitely set the tone, Mike, as you see number 21, Isaiah, right there going into the end zone, but then ends up fumbling that ball. But guess who? Colin Freitas comes up with that wide receiver on that fumble recovery for the touchdown. Weaver's been tremendous in the run and the pass. There he runs one in for a touchdown. Rifles one down the middle here. Now they're going to get another big time bounce as Yusef Reddick picks up the fumbled ball, runs that one in for a touchdown. So it's been all the Patriots' way here in the first half. Whatever they tried to do has turned up gold. Here's another good pass once again to Reddick. threaded that needle, Weaver did, and did a nice job with Reddick getting the touchdown pass.
Well, and the significance of all those early scores, it got Keith Brader into this kind of a game, you know, with an inexperienced quarterback and inexperienced offense. And, you know, again, we talked about it. They don't have a varsity player that's got a varsity point, and this isn't the game they wanted to play. There's the interception return by Todd Micah, and then have to be impressed with Weaver. He's got a nice feel for the game with people flying around. There's another one of his favored receivers, Will Vilecki. Those first half highlights presented by D.E. Kressman Insurance Agency. As indeed, it is 48-0 entering this third quarter. And of course, that does mean the mercy rule will be in effect. Well, time will basically just fly by in this half. Look now at our overhead door halftime statistics. And I think they're going to be pretty lopsided as well.
Now you take a look at first downs, 8-3, real big advantage. Total yards, 208-91. Passing yards, which you would expect with Weaver coming in this ball game with 121. Dieruff with 87, not too bad, a little bit more respectable there. Time of possession, and it's funny, this is what tells you about statistics and how you can't believe them sometimes. Time of possession, big advantage, 14-49-9-11 for Dieruff. But every time Freedom got the ball, twice within under a minute and a half, they scored touchdowns there in the first half.
Yeah, about 0 for 7 on third down conversions for Dieruff. That just could not be if they were going to be successful in this game. Walters Pharmacy, great play of the half. This will be interesting. They didn't let us in on this one. Freitas and the alert, Yusuf Reddick, is our Walters Pharmacy great play of the half. We didn't know what was coming up there, Jim. I do know one thing. The boys in the truck had an awful lot to choose from in that first half. For the new look Freedom Patriots, the new uniforms, the new jerseys being sported here this evening. And they seem to be pretty comfortable in them. I guess the big question being asked is, you and I were talking to a number of the fans making their way here around J. Bernie Crum Stadium. I guess, you know, is Freedom as good as they are showing here? Is Dieruff, you know, not, you know, along in their progression? And, you know, really the only answer to both those questions is going to surface in the next couple of weeks. As we mentioned, Freedom is going to get, obviously, their most severe test of the season coming up next week when they host Parkland. So we'll learn a little bit more there. And in terms of Dieruff, you know, it didn't get a whole lot easier. And that's something you and I discussed, that, you know, while there might be some teams be better, it's going to be interesting to see what Emmaus does tonight at Easton. How far along are they for real? I think everybody agrees they're a better team. Are they better or good enough to compete at Cottingham Stadium with arguably one of the best programs in the area?
Yeah, it's going to be a real big question to find out what happens down there in that Easton Emmaus game, Cottingham Stadium, and that mystique, an awful tough thing to beat. I know Joe Bottolieri's team is a lot better than they were last year, you know, a lot more experience. They played a lot of young kids last year, but we'll have to find out what happens down there. And in this case here, Mike, you know, it's a good thing that Keith Brader is back for a second time, because he's been there before. He's gone to another program. He's come back. He's going to be able to look at this in a much better filter than he had the first time he's here, and the frustration that it caused the first time, I'm sure. And I think he knows what has to be done. Remember, they started at rock bottom, and that's the thing everybody's got to remember. And, you know, and tonight they really got off to a very, very bad start. And when you're that situation and that poor, you can't get off to those bad starts.
60 in uniform for Dieruff. That is a much larger number than what Jake Williams wound up closing out last year's season with. 22 seniors, 25 juniors, and 13 sophomores. And here is Jeff Schaefer. Nice high, deep kick. He is truly a weapon for this team. Fielded by the Huskies. And this is number 20, Alex Rodriguez, with a good return. And Rodriguez getting it up to about the 44-yard line.
Rodriguez has done a lot of good things tonight on special teams for the Huskies. We talked about him before. Came down and made a nice tackle on a punt team coverage a couple of minutes ago in the second quarter. So now he does a good job of returning that one.
He's tackled by number 60, Christian O'Connor.
Christian O'Connor on the stop for Freedom. Another score we heard at the half. Wilson leading Saucon Valley 21-0. That ball game at the half. Apparently there's a little validation into that statement about practicing against a state championship team for a whole year and playing all those extra weeks. Brent Kopp apparently has some tools left there to contend for Colonial League Championship. First carry of the ball game for number 8, Courtney Coles.
Number 8, Courtney Coles with the carry. Run down by number 9.
You see a good look at this as number 24 for the Patriots gets blown out of there. Spencer Kaufman, the linebacker, opening up a big hole for number 8, Courtney Coles, to operate in.
Whitehall looking to make a 2-0 start under Tony Trisciani, leading Northampton 13-7. That ball game has moved into the third quarter. Highlights Monday night on Lehigh Valley Sports Scene. Here's Odom, and Odom twists his way inside the 35-yard line. Jim, what do you look for here if you're, you know, looking, say, as a Dieruff fan and a Dieruff follower? What do you look for out of the Huskies in this second half?
Well, I think Coach Brader went in the locker room and said, look it, we're going to run the ball whether you like it or not, and that's what I want to see here in the second half. Forget about the score. Pretend we're starting at 0-0. I want you to run the football. That's what's going to be the most important thing, running the football. And I think that that's what they've come out here and they've established it so far.
Well, that's what they wanted to do at the beginning of this ball game. Here's Odom on the option. Gilmore on the toss. Stiff arm to, it looks like, his advantage. He's very close to a first down.
Number 22, Rodney Gilmore with the
this
carry.
Also then,
he's tackled by number 6.
As we get a look at
Joseph
the replay, boy, what a push-up field by number 86. That's Sean Reese, a reserve defensive lineman, 6'2", 195. That's a nice play to disrupt the timing of that offensive set.
Well, the group that's in there now for the Patriots, happy to get it some playing time, so they're going to give you their best effort right now up front. Busted play here now for the Huskies.
Yeah, Odom was looking for someone to hang on to and, or hand off to. And Eric, give us an opportunity to discuss once again the mercy rule, Jim, here in this scenario. Well, we'll pick that thought up in a minute. Let's visit second half with Regina.
Mike, I got to speak with head coach from Freedom, Jason Roeder, at halftime, and I said, you know, obviously you have to be happy with the way things are going. He said, yes, we wanted to come in here. We wanted to take things very aggressively. There was no way we were taking Dieruff lightly. So he said, I'm very happy with the way things happened. I said, what about Logan Davis kicking, you know, getting that kickoff return 92 yards for a touchdown? And he said, obviously that was a great step for us. We wanted to keep in our game, take control of the ball, and we actually did that. He said, we have a great offensive game. Now we're going to see a lot of our younger kids getting some game time experience, but he said, obviously, we know we wanted to come in here and do the things we did right, and they did that tonight. He's very happy with his ball club right now.
Yeah, and he should be. You know, that's a sign of a mature ball club. Nice tackle by Dylan Markwith, reserved cornerback. You know, discuss that mercy rule again, Jim. This is, you know, one of the areas, and, you know, heck, you and I are in a scenario here where the clock's going to run out and probably, you know, in the long run do us a favor. But in terms of a football coach and developing a football team, I mean, let's look at it both ways. I know Dieruff's getting it handed to him 48-0, but here is a team in desperate need of varsity experience and reps. So they're going to be cut out of that as this pass falls incomplete. And Freedom, as you heard Regina report, this is an opportunity for Jason Roeder to get a lot of guys in there and get some varsity experience who have been practicing just like everybody else. You know, I don't know that I'm in favor of it. You know, football is, you know, a tough sport. You know, for lack of a better way to put it, I don't know that the mercy thing, I understand it, I know why it's there for these scenarios, but I just think it's limiting coaches and perhaps the development of some players.
Yeah, I think that what happens is when you have programs that have dwindling numbers in attendance, Mike, that, you know, those kids say, well, why should I go out there? Because even though, you know, I might get a chance to play a little bit, they're going to get mercy ruled all year, and I probably won't get in that much whatsoever, so why should I even try? And I think that's where it really hurts a lot of the programs that are trying to establish, you know, and work their way up from the bottom. And that's the thing that you said, you know, a prime example is tonight at Dieruff. You know, they want to come out here. They want to get the work. They're here to get better. They're not here to turn around and say, we're going to walk through the motions for the second half. And that's where it hurts those kind of teams. And I think that there's a lot of debate about it. There's some people who are in favor of it. Some people are not in favor of it. Some states have voted it out. Other states have voted it in lately. And, you know, some people are saying the numbers should be even bigger. So there's a lot of debates with a lot of different things. And, you know, I guess the thing that's really hard to determine is there are some programs, like, you know, last year's Dieruff team obviously was one that was really would be a candidate for that kind of team because of the low numbers, because of the score at halftime, a lot of those
games. And not
games.
Having second team players to put in, I understand that. Tyree Pompey missing an interception opportunity, and Patriots will take over. And again, you have a fumbled snap. And, you know, for these second teamers for Freedom, Jason Roeder, I'm sure, has a close eye on them. Now, he's still looking for guys who could have an impact as it goes on. So these will be some important snaps for these guys. And it has been Ryan Tress since late in the second quarter.
Well, the other thing, Mike, that you look at here, and let's face it, it's still high school football. You look at Freedom. Yes, they got more numbers. Yes, they got talented kids this year, a little bit more talented kids than normal. But guess what? They're one or two players away with injuries of being right back to where they were last year. So these guys that are in there now got to get those positive reps, got to get some varsity playing time and get that experience so that if somebody goes down with an injury, they're going to be able to step in.
Tress under center, handing to his deep back, all second teamers in there. That is number 25, Tristan Burke. Burke in his junior year, 5'7".
Number 25, Tristan Burke with the carry.
Numbers on Freedom this year. Exactly. They have 70 in uniform, 18 seniors, 29 juniors, and 23 10th graders. Heavily loaded on that junior class, so it could be a pretty good run right now for this program. Loss of a yard will bring up third down and 11. Press to throw, forced out of the pocket. Slips a tackler across the 40, has a first down, gets another block at the 46. He is finally brought down far side. Looked like number 85, Shamar Lawson Davis.
Well, he gets a big block inside there for number 26. And Serrano, and then, or excuse me, 23, Serrano. And that's what really keys his ability to get out of that backfield and make that nice run up the sidelines. As you said, Mike, number 85, Lawson Davis on the stop.
Northampton has just taken a one-point lead over Whitehall. Your score, 14-13. More Lehigh Valley Conference football tomorrow night on Two Sports. Central Catholic at Bethlehem Catholic. Live coverage at 7 o'clock following our live coverage, actually not following immediately, but tomorrow afternoon, Lehigh and Villanova NCAA college football. Third Sean quarter Toronto being presented by Kleckner's Appliances. Two locations to serve you, one in Whitehall, one in Emmaus. Last year, Huskies were shut out in 5 of the 10 ball games. Scored a season-high 22 in a losing effort against Nazareth. And are on the verge here of being blanked for the second time this season, having lost last week 13-0 to Stroudsburg South. Third down and 9. Pate's in no particular hurry. Wilson's taken a 24-0 lead over Saucon Valley. That football game has moved into the fourth. Highlights of that one on Monday night's Lehigh Valley Sports Scene. Sports Scene, of course, a Monday through Friday Service Electric Cable Television exclusive at 6:30 and 9 o'clock.
Offside, 6 and 9:30. Blue. Still third down. Ready, here we go.
Now, Jim, I don't know if you heard. Interesting scenario. Remember last week we did the Whitehall-Becca game, and Whitehall faking the extra point, going for the 2 to win that ball game late. Saturday morning, the two teams met in a JV game. Whitehall scored late in the ball game, faked the extra point, made the 2 to win by 1.
Oh, I did hear that.
I thought you'd be interested to hear that.
That's,
I think,
crazy.
That's nuts. I'm insane is what it is. Zeps have...
They've fallen in love with that
point. Why not? They haven't
been successful every time for it.
Every time they've tried it, of course, a couple of years ago, they had great success with it. And riding that deal all the way to the District 11 championship game where they lost to Pottsville. How many times they win that year on a fake field goal or extra point?
Well,
it was the
game before that. They beat Abington Heights on it.
Right. Fourth down 4 here.
Excuse me, Mike. That team, of course, led by Regina's brother and company. now participating in the Lehigh program.
There's a pass over the middle, in and out of the hands.
You'll get a chance to see him tomorrow.
Oh, pretty good throw there by Tress. Yes, Lehigh hosting Villanova live at 1 o'clock.
Number 12, Ryan Tress's pass. Intended for number 86, Sean Reese, goes incomplete.
Oh, nice pass by Tress. He gets it inside to the hands, but can't hang on.
Impressed with this attack here by Freedom. Running a lot of vertical routes, spread you right and left. We'll look forward to next Friday night. Jim and I will be over at Bethlehem Area School District Stadium, where Freedom will be hosting Parkland. No score to report tonight on the Trojans. They're playing against Nazareth. Huskies take over on down. Courtney Coles on the carry. So, Jim, you've been a lot around a lot of
number
these coaches
with the carry.
On the Dieruff staff. You know, we've gotten pretty close to Coach Brader, of course, Coach Panny, and, you know, Coach Schmidt, who's a former, you know, Kisco Award winner. Donnie Luber's still involved. Billy Birch is still over there. And where do they go? Where do they take this now Monday? You know, they'll look at film and they'll look at this. And, you know, where do they take this come Monday's practice?
Well, I think they're in a situation where they know that this was going to happen one of these times along the road. And, you know, they got to just drill it into the kids' head that it's only a bump in the road. It's not continual as it was before. And there's a good play right there from Odom to number 11. Byers on a nice pass up the sidelines, and they're going to try to bring out those kind of points. You know, we came out in the second half, we competed, even though it might be against the second group from Freedom, but we've made progress. Last year, when you were in this position, and a lot of you guys sitting in this room were in that position, last year you didn't compete. So I think that they can build on the competitive thing. I think they can build on the arm of Odom, and I think that they've done some good jobs with the receivers here in the third quarter.
Yeah, Odom showing you his arm strength, as that will do it for the third quarter. 48-0, Pate, back with our final 12 after this.
That routine maintenance can add years to the life of your garage door? While repairs and adjustments should only be made by a qualified technician, take a few moments each month to inspect and test your door, following the instructions in your owner's manual.
Brought to you by ABE Doors and Windows, the Valley's garage door headquarters for sales and selection, along with routine maintenance and expert guaranteed repairs. ABE Doors and Windows, because quality doesn't cost, it pays.
Well, the clocks are running here on the Mercy Roll as we welcome you back to J. Bernie Crum Stadium. Fourth quarter underway, and 12 minutes will go by in a hurry with that Mercy Roll. Pate's looking to improve to 2-0.
There's a fumble on the play. Fumble's recovered by the Patriots, number 88, Keith Ward.
Fumble on that last play, and it was recovered by number 88, Keith Ward, for the Pates. Yeah, no way to sugarcoat this for the Huskies. There's a lot of rebuilding to do. Let's visit with Regina.
Mike, finishing your thought at the end of the third quarter on the Dieruff Huskies and being competitive here in the LVC and just across the board. A couple of the players told me this week during practice, you know, it's something that we are getting now in practice that we didn't have last year, because with only 20, 25 players on the roster, it was so tough to see some good looks at practice. The scout team was not, you know, obviously there's starters on both ways playing on the scout team as well. So he said this year, you know, we have that opportunity all week long during practice that is eventually going to help us out in the field.
Yeah, nice play defensively number by number 65, Justin Figueroa.
He's brought down by number 57.
Getting Tristan Burke.
I think, Mike, one of the things that the coaches are going to have to do is they're just going to have to use those famous words, trust me, we're going to get better. Just listen to what we tell you to do week to week, and we're going to get better. They were in such a low esteem part of it last year with, you know, between the scores, between the non-wins, between the non-scoring of touchdowns. you know, they had nowhere to go but up. But it's also, you got to make sure that you trust in the people that you have there now. And they couldn't have a better group than Brader, because he's been there before, knows the kids, teaches in the school, which is of utmost importance, as Coach Roeder even said to us before the game.
Jim Moniz, of course, the principal at Dieruff, and Keith Brader, I think every time I talk with him, mentions the great support that he gets from the current principal at Dieruff, a graduate there and an athlete at the Eastside School. Yeah, make no mistake about it, however, this is going to be a long bus ride back to the east side of Allentown. This one still has to sting a little bit, but it's all part of the growing pains that you endure. Here's Tress. Firing downfield, pass falls incomplete.
Number 12, Ryan Tress is passing.
Of course, pretty well documented how former Dieruff star Andre Reed, now running a golf tournament in his hometown of San Diego, California,
has been number 24, Kevin Azar,
generating some income towards the Dieruff weight program. They have a touchdown club they've started. Mentioned Betty Reinhardt in the first half, and Yarnell's catering, feeding the guys in between practices. These are some of the things that weren't happening over at Dieruff. Take a little time. Here's a muff snap on the punt. The pass now is complete to Timothy Weingar. Weingar has enough for a first down. And that is a couple of times here tonight that the Patriots have been able to turn lemons into lemonade. A couple of fumbles on their part, went for touchdowns in the first half.
That looked like it was done. And here you see Keith Brader. It's all he could do is laugh, you know, and smile and say, you know, what are you going to do? When it's going that way, it's going that way. And, you know, there's the difference between the Keith Brader of 2007 and the Keith Brader that was here before, Mike. If they had that camera shot on him a couple years ago, he would have been so disgusted, so distraught, because he's learned to deal with that, you know, and now he knows that that's the kind of things that are going to happen, and we're just going to deal with it, we're going to roll with it. We're going to get better. That's the thing. The other thing that we didn't talk about, they left kids home tonight. Last year, they couldn't afford to leave anybody in the locker room, let alone leave them at home. You know what I mean? Because they only had 30 kids at some point a lot of the time. So there's a lot of positives to be looking at for Coach Brader and Dieruff.
So Ray O'Connell used to be the principal at Trexler Middle School, now retired. He's very active with, you know, the sports programs in the city of Allentown. I saw him outside his home a couple of weeks ago. He said, Mike, we had to buy 5 new helmets for Dieruff football. Now, those are positive signs. You know, you're not seeing it tonight, obviously, and I don't think, Jim, you're trying to, and I know I'm not trying to sugarcoat this thing, because it's not pretty right now, and there's a lot of improvement needs, but, you know, those are some of the growing pains and some of the things that, you know, any program we've seen, whether it's been Parkland before Rich Nizak got there, or Tim Muntzman at Liberty after a couple of lean years there, you know, they've all endured, and they've all gone through, you know, what it takes to get the championship caliber.
And in this day and age, when kids, you know, would rather quit and laugh at everybody else who stuck it out, you got to admire that group that's out there right now, that group that's on the sidelines, and that group that's out there right now, and the 11 that's on the field, because that's the kind of thing in this day and age that's an admirable trait. And you know, my hat's off to them for sticking it out all summer with the camp and the off-season program, and they're going to get better. They're going to get better. And he knows which way to go with it as well.
We've said it many times before.
Holding, white. Second down.
It is easy to go to practice on Monday after a win. It is easy to go to practice on Monday when you're part of what is going to be a championship team. Go there when you know you haven't scored in 2 weeks and haven't won in over 2 years. Not that these players haven't, you know, they haven't been a part of that. This is just 2 games this year. But they know that it's there, that it exists. And to have 65 kids back there on the practice field on Monday will be the positive that comes out of this for Dieruff.
And the other thing that wasn't in place, Mike, that's in place now is the middle school football program. I'm sure Ray O'Connell has talked to you about that. That has been a big plus. You know, Andy Poloni at Allen has talked about that. They've done an excellent job with their middle school football program. The feeder programs are in place. That's a thing that wasn't at Dieruff, you know, the last couple years as well. So you're starting to get all those things to be lined up and positive steps for the Huskies.
Well, that'll bring some experience in terms of playing the sport of football. Third down and 8. Tress handing off to the running back. A lot of players shuffling in and out.
I think Alex Rodriguez came up with that football that time, Mike.
Fumble on the play. The fumble was recovered by the Huskies, number 30, Austin Falls.
Crediting Austin Falls with the fumble recovery, now number 30.
You see number 57 in there, Jonathan Fulmer as well.
Mike, you guys are looking at the Freedom Cheerleaders right now. They are coached by Alicia Zito in her third season. Last year, this squad of 28 girls went out to California and participated in Jam Fest, which is a national tournament. They placed first out of about 15 high school teams. So this team has a very competitive drive. They are known across the nation. They start their competitions around December, training for them. And this year, they'll be going to Disney World in March. There's 28 girls this year on the squad. 20 of them went to California last year.
They didn't even have to win the Super Bowl and they're going to Disney World, huh? We have some terrific cheerleading squads in the area. Of course, Easton has been mentioned on a number of occasions, and I don't want to leave anybody out because there are an awful lot of them. We've got a quarterback change here. Joe Ocellus, a 6'1", 160-pound junior, and Joe is the brother to Rich Ocellus, who is the quarterback's coach for Dieruff High School. Rich, a good quarterback in his day as well at Dieruff High School. So his brother, an opportunity to see some playing time. And again, it'll go back to the point, Jim, you and I were talking about it, developing underclassmen. Fourth quarter being presented by Kleckner's Appliances with two locations to serve you, one in Whitehall, one in Emmaus. Here's Ocellus to throw. Well, gonna tuck and run, has a first down. And about 6 to 7 yards more down near the 30-yard line.
There you see number 16 going off the field. You
number know, 16, Joseph.
Couldn't have some a better tutor than his older brother there. Yeah. His older brother put some good statistics up there for the Dieruff Huskies in his high school career.
Yeah, part of some very good football teams. First down and 10, ball at the 30. Huskies trying to get on the board for the first time this season. Shut out last week, 13-0 against East Stroudsburg South in a game. They were able to get inside the 20 on five occasions. Ocellus overthrows and it'll be picked off. Interception by number 27, Thomas Higgins. And Higgins' return will get it out to the 28-yard line.
Ocellus' pass intercepted by number 27, Thomas Higgins.
Higgins, a sophomore, and another example of youngster who's been there. He's going to see most of his action this year on the JV team, I'm sure, but opportunity to pick one off under the lights in a varsity appearance. You never forget those moments as a youngster, as it develops from that point, and you hopefully it turns into a successful career with the Paints. Remember, this the first of two here tonight. We have Emmaus at Easton, same night coverage at 10 o'clock. Huskies at Bethlehem Catholic next Saturday. Return home to host Nazareth on the 21st. Home here against Liberty. At Emmaus,
number 40, Jack Carvalho,
home against
Harry.
Whitehall, travel to play at Parkland,
Justin Figueroa.
And then we'll close out the regular season against Central and Allen. Obviously, both games will be played here. For Freedom, their schedule next week, Parkland, then Central Catholic on a Saturday on a return trip here to J. Bernie Crum Stadium. That game on the 22nd. They'll host Allen. Play at Al Erdesi Field on the October 5th against Northampton. Host Easton on the 12th. Saturday game with Becca on the 20th. And Nazareth and Liberty to close out the regular season. Hello, Dwayne.
Number 32, Dionysius Curry with the carry. He's tackled by number 65, Justin Figueroa.
Curry on that last carry, Figueroa on the stop. New quarterback into the ball game is Thomas Lutey. Lutey's a 6'1", 175-pound sophomore.
Run the ball.
You see Coach
Roeder
has gotten these Patriots off to some great starts in his 3 years here.
I am anxious, Jim, for next Friday night. I don't know about you, but that is going to be a good test for a football team that looks like they have some tools and the makings that can become a very good football team as this team goes on, as this year goes on.
That's going to be an outstanding ball game next week. A big test for both teams. You know, Parkland, as we said, we've talked about before, once again in that rotation, does not play Easton or Liberty in this season. So it'll be interesting to see as they go up against the Patriots next Friday night.
Well, and of course, as we mentioned in that first half, I might just want to see what sidelines they're going to be on. We can have fun, can't we?
There'll be a lot of things going on there next week.
Oh, sure will. I'll tell you, there might be a lot of folks not knowing where to go next week. Time to meet our Yakos player of the game. I think, Jim, we were both impressed with the quarterback, Joe Weaver, 6'1", 175-pound senior. He is our Yakos player of the game.
Well, he can do it from both ends, and you see his running ability here as he scored a touchdown, but in the past 2 weeks, it's been that arm that has really been a plus for the Patriots. There you see, 5 for 7, 121 yards, 2 touchdowns, 3 rushes for 20 yards, and a touchdown as well.
Yeah, I think in any offense that appears to have this many weapons, there's one guy in the middle of it that needs to be the hub, and he certainly appears to fit that bill right now for Jason Roeder's Freedom Patriots, looking to improve to 2-0. Only ever been to the District 11 tournament. That was one time when Jim Morgans was their head coach. This is a good step for them. Ocellus with perhaps one more opportunity. Airing it out near side. Might have a guy, and it's dropped. In and out of the hands of Rondell Byers. And that really typifies the night as time will expire. And Freedom will win this one going away by a final of 48-0. And Jim, as we mentioned, you know, we look at Freedom.
Final score for this evening.
How good a football team can they become? That'll be the question that'll be asked as they leave J. Bernie Crum Stadium tonight.
Right, the measuring stick will be next week, obviously, going against former Freedom coach Jim Morgans and Parkland team that will be a very good matchup next Friday night. So I think that they've tuned themselves up very well here. They've scored an awful lot of points in the first two games, so it'll be interesting to see if they can continue that trend next week against Parkland.
Yeah, for the Huskies, and Keith Braden will be back to the drawing board trying put together some broken hearts, perhaps. You work hard to get to, you know, game night, and you know, when you come up empty like this and, you know, fail to score again for, you know, second time on the season. But the one thing you can rest assured, they'll be back to work on Monday. Let's visit now with winning head coach Jason Roeder.
Coach, you told me at halftime you were happy with the way, you know, your offense played and defense played. Talk a little bit about them.
Well, like I said, we talked about, you know, maintaining intensity and come out and playing hard and doing the things we do and do them well. And we got a nice opening kickoff. I mean, we got a couple lucky bounces go our way, which always helps. But I was happy with the kids' effort and the intensity they came out with tonight.
2 weeks in a row now, you got off to that fast start. How important is that?
Well, I think that always helps. I mean, you know, the true test is when we don't get off to that fast start, how we're going to respond. But, you know, we'll take that fast start anytime we can get it.
Next week, Parkland, I know it's premature, but thoughts on the game?
It's not premature. It's not premature at all. You know, we know what's next, and you know, we're going to enjoy this for a little bit, and it's time to get to work, and you know, we got to get ready for one of the big boys.
Thanks, Coach. Guys, back up to you.
A lot of folks in the Lehigh Valley think that he is one of the very truly bright and talented head coaches in this area, Jim, as we look at the stats.
You take a look at second half, evened it out a little bit more. Total yards still 290 to 181, but the fact is that time of possession, very misleading. Freedom did what they needed to do when they had their possessions, and it all started with that opening kickoff.
Yeah, turnovers, 6 of them there by Dieruff. They were very, you know, they weren't successful on third downs, and you know, kind of got a draw in time of possession, but that kind of misleading as this one plays out. 290 to 181, the total yards, and you know, just doesn't include all of the things that Freedom was able to make happen in this ball game. J. Joe Weaver is our Yakos, Joseph Weaver, I should say, our Yakos player of the game, first caller Monday morning after 9 o'clock, 610-434-7833. Identify Joseph as our Yakos player of the game. You'll win a gift certificate from the good folks from Yakos. That will do it from J. Bernie Crum Stadium. We certainly hope you enjoyed it on this Friday night. We have another one to come tonight, 10 o'clock, same night coverage, Emmaus Easton. We understand that's a good ball game. W. Jason Ware. Joining us, Ryan Ware. Why don't I keep calling you Jason? You keep giving me different names. Ryan Ware joining us, the recent Penn State graduate, as our stat guy. Welcome aboard. For Jim Wills, Regina Potocny, the birthday girl. We'll see her tomorrow afternoon with Lehigh football. For all of us here at Two Sports, Donnie Long, our director and producer, I'm Mike Zambelli. Thanks for watching Lehigh Valley Conference Football. Freedom Patriots a winner, 48-0. Now 2-0, the Huskies at 0-2.
A lot of companies say they'll customize your home, but at Spectrum Homes, we actually do. From floor plan to facade, from carpentry to cabinetry, your fingerprint is on every part of the blueprint. After all, your home is an expression of who you are, your wants, your needs, and your lifestyle. Spectrum Homes. The difference is in the details.
Since the Overhead Door Company makes the original overhead door, the people who install and service them take them pretty seriously. Call or log on for the overhead door dealer nearest you.
Hey, football fans, if you love dealing with a winning team, head to the leader, Kleckner's in Whitehall and Emmaus, for the fabulous GE kickoff sale. Browse our huge selection of GE ranges, GE refrigerators, GE dishwashers, GE washers, and GE dryers. Now at Kleckner's, get great savings plus free delivery, free haul away of old, a full parts department, and their own factory trained techs. Stop in today. See why Kleckner's has been serving the Lehigh Valley since 1945. Two locations, Kleckner's, 2177 MacArthur Road in Whitehall, and 575 Chestnut Street, Emmaus.
Hi, my name's Brett Comp. I'm the head football coach at Wilson Area High School. And in today's skill set, we'd like to demonstrate better pass receiving skills. We have three key points of emphasis that we'd like to go over today. Here to help me demonstrate are Anthony Ventura, number 12, and Brian Cooper, number 86. First key point of emphasis is use your hands. Too often we see receivers try to trap the ball against their body. A lot of the times the ball bounces out with equal or greater velocity than the pass was thrown. So using the hands is very important. Second key point is looking at it all the way with your eyes. Too often receivers take their eye off the ball a little too early. Collision occurs. They try to get more yards before they've actually caught the ball. Ball goes on the ground. So they look it in with their eyes all the time. And the third key point is making sure that we secure the ball with three points of anchor: the nose, forearm, and also the armpit. So you'll see them put all three things together now, using the eyes, the hands, and also securing the ball. We'll over-exaggerate this even when we're warming up. to ensure that we've created a good habit with our wide receivers. So to review, to be a better pass receiver, make sure you use your hands. Make sure you look the ball all the way in with your eyes and also secure the ball. And that's your skill set for today.